Today, traceability and its origins are taken for granted. We are so used to hearing the term from farm to fork. Yet, according to the World Health Organization, almost 600 million, that's 1 in 10 people, get sick every year from eating contaminated food. And 420,000 die. Those deaths are caused by fraudsters tampering with our food supply chain. Yet, we hear little in our daily lives. In January 2016, the World Economic Forum told us to be ready for the fourth industrial revolution. The digital age and the fact that the world was going to change faster than ever. This new era that builds and extends the impact of digitization in new and unanticipated ways. 15 months later, the world was told to prepare for the fifth industrial revolution, the rise of artificial intelligence, machine learning, and the Internet of Things. Never before have we seen such speed of change, from self-driving and automated cars to homes that know you're close and turn on the lights and the heating. Just look at the changes in our mobile phones. Where would we be today without our smartphone? In our day-to-day lives, Alexa and Siri has changed how so many people live. But when a farmer steps out the door of their house and into their farm, they're using technology and practices that haven't changed much since the turn of the 20th century. Yes, tractors are more comfortable and milking machines have become more automated. But tracking and tracing our food is done largely with pen and paper. And it's duplicated across so many systems that it causes some of the biggest issues. You might find it hard to believe, but most farms have hardly changed at all in the last 100 years. This will in turn affect every single one of us in the coming months and years if we do not look at our food and how we consume it. So, I want to take you on a journey. As a butcher's son, I followed my father into the family business. I loved taking raw produce and turning it into something that not only tasted good, but it's something that people wanted. I learned so many skills and took great pride in my work. I love listening to my customers and explaining the origins of their produce, where they came from, and how to cook them. Nothing for me felt better than seeing an empty counter at the end of an evening. And as a trusted member of the community, it was a privilege to provide such a service. But my curiosity did not stop there. I spent time in and across the supply chain, working with fantastic and inspirational people. I learned to appreciate the effort required daily, not only feeding our nation, but supporting farm exports and international trade. Alongside my work, I had a passion for electronics, and I loved tinkering with circuit boards, computers, and I chose to develop that passion into a professional career. And so I studied for my professional qualifications and built a career as a technology specialist. I am glad to say that over the years, I have traveled the world, working alongside global organizations, leading technology companies, delivering solutions for government, healthcare, aerospace, and the food and drink sector. Now, being part butcher, part techie, I wasn't happy just sitting on the sidelines and wanted to utilize my passion for food and farming and knowledge from the technology sector to address the global issue of food traceability and provenance. Despite traceability being taken for granted, the age-old problem of food fraud is more significant now than ever. The first recorded incident of food fraud dates back to the times of the Roman Empire, when wine was diluted or mixed to ensure guests present had enough to drink. The thought was, the more they drank, the less they worried about quality. I wouldn't like to try that today. Fast forward to today, and the issue is much more prolific. The horse meat scandal of 2014, reported by our own Professor Elliot of Queen's, highlighted the scale of adulteration and the impact to human health. A 2016 PwC report outlined the global impact of food fraud, and the cost to the economy was in excess of $40 billion. And the Centre for Counter-Fraud Studies at the University of Portsmouth estimates $11.97 billion for UK possible losses. You may ask, what does this mean to you and to me? Well, just like any loss, that loss has to be recovered from someone and somewhere. It is estimated that 5 pence in every pound is added to everyday items. That means an average shop of £50, £2.50 goes towards that cost. Mislabeling a product or wrongly portraying its quality, its safety, its origin, its freshness is just simply fraud. Dilution, misrepresentation, adulteration, even fake rice are among some of the cases recorded by the Institute of Global Food Security at Queen's. Sad to say, but our food is not the only thing affected. Medicines, supplements, and vitamins have measured a meteoric rise in cases. So the need for change has never been greater. I remember addressing a class of graduates in the US just before the first lockdown in 2020. And I had the opportunity to ask the question, what is innovation? Someone from the back of the room shouted, innovation is answering the questions the future is asking. You see, during the pandemic, the world innovated more in 10 months than it had in the previous 10 years. When faced with adversity, we worked together to achieve some fantastic things. Greater collaboration, more outstanding communication. Yes, even the family Zoom quiz. So I say it's time to rethink our food supply and apply new thinking, faster innovation, more collaboration, and most of all, greater transparency. You see, I know what I'm doing. I've already done it, but I know we can do it better. I was one of the first specialists in the world to utilise blockchain technology to help the craft beer and whiskey industry communicate with their customer and tell the story and passion behind the brand. From the quality of the water to the barley and the hops, even the story of the individual team members involved in the process. That story of the brewer's passion and all of the data was contained within a scannable code that was unique to each bottle. All you had to do was use your mobile phone, authenticate your age, and you would see the video from the day of harvest, photo and dates from the day of production, along with the records of bottling and proof of provenance. This effective yet simple solution gave customers confidence and comfort to know what their product was, exactly what it was supposed to be, who made it and where it came from. I asked the question, what if we could do for our food what we did for the drink sector? What if we could make this level of transparency and proof of provenance commonplace across our food? By embracing change and collaborating with our producers, processors, and supply chain members, we can not only see and ensure who our food comes from, we can also reduce our food miles, 100% guarantee provenance, support sustainability, and establish a connected community by trusting the products we consume. You see, my family are obsessed with scanning food packaging to get information about its calorific and calorie content. Why not utilize this simple technology to take it further and include trusted information from the farmer, the processor, the distributor, and the retailer to not only tell the story and passion behind the brand, but to prove provenance and create positive economic value for our economy. By connecting to our food and trading on the trust economy, we can promote our amazing produce globally, establish new trade agreements, create more jobs, and support transformation and innovation across our communities. It's about the little steps. It's about realizing there is a problem and meeting those problems with a solution. It's about working together. It's about giving voice to the farmers and their products. This technology is with us today and helps us to unlock value across the community we serve, the land we work, and the food we eat. Renowned author Rachel Botsman states, "Trust enables innovation." And as consumers, we all need to play our part and demand greater transparency. So join me in our provenance journey to utilize technology, people, and dynamic processes across our supply chain to eat the food we trust and trust the food we eat.